I got a feeling that tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good
Hello,
night.
All you amazing that Hawks out there. Are you ready for the by far the cringiest Hawk Talk you will ever see?
We hope, because that's what we have in store for you, so here we go.
Hey Emma, the thought of moving to Horizon North makes me cringe. How about you?
Definitely, but a good attitude will be the best way to counter the cringe and make it the best possible experience.
Oh yeah, after all, it'd be our last time as middle schoolers, so we might as well make the best of it.
As far as transportation information and other logistics, stay tuned for more info.
Here's some info on our annual Fill the Bus event.
This is guaranteed not to be cringy as we round up canned food donations from people in the Albertsons parking lot.
When does it take place?
It's the Saturday before the Super Bowl.
All you cringy 8th graders out there, you can sign up to volunteer on this day and earn some service hours, eh?
One thing we Hawks take pride in is showing awesome character, and this month we are working on fairness.
That means treating people equally and respecting them as well as their ideas.
Sounds like another way to make Horizon a less cringy place.
Oh, shizzle. Now let's respect the country and sign the pledge.
Stand by, one, two.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America. And to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Good, good night, a feeling that tonight's gonna
be. Hey, students of impeccable character.
Welcome back to this week's edition of Character Day.
Good job on last week's dare, Hawks.
Remind me, what was last week's dare again?
Last week's dare was stay in touch.
Wasn't that where you write a letter to a loved one that's in another state or city?
Yep, that's the one. And good job to all the Hawks that completed this dare. Just because this dare has passed doesn't mean you shouldn't stay in touch with your friends and family.
Next week's dare is mad respect, yo. This dare asks you to think about a person that you most look up to and make a list of characteristics that that person has.
That's a great dare, because if you think about it, all the great things that a person does, maybe you could be more like them and build on your character.
For sure. With that, Hawks, we challenge you to complete next week's dare. Now let's see this dare in action.
That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good, good night.
Zach, have you heard of next week's dare?
Yeah, I think it was mad respect, yo.
Who do you look up to?
I look up to Martin Luther King Jr. Because he's honest, and he's caring, and he practices love. Is there someone you look up to, Jackie?
No.
All right. Let's see you do the character dare in action, Hawks.
Yeah.
Good morning, Horizon Hawks. It's great to see you guys on this episode of the Frantic Files. I have a few things to share with you guys that are important. The end of the second quarter is going to be this next Tuesday, January 29th, so make sure that you're getting your tests retaken, homework assignments turned in, so that you can have the best grade possible and that you're understanding what's happening in class. So be really tuned in and just being responsible with the things that you need to do. That first day of the third quarter starts on Wednesday, the 30th, so you will have, many of you will have a new elective course, so just make sure that you get your schedule out of first period and you will know where you need to go from there. Hard to believe we're already halfway through the school year. My message to you guys is keep working hard. That effort does pay off, and your teachers are there to help you out. So please make sure that you take advantage of talking with them if you're not understanding things, so that you can learn all that you can. So anyways, challenge for you guys. Next in the files, I just want to make sure that I talk a little bit about the Hawks Rock tickets that teachers hand out, that I hand out. We are going to have the January donut parties this next Friday, a week from today. on February 1st. So I'll do a drawing and I will pick a 6th grade, 7th grade, and 8th grade winner. And remember, all those donut parties are sponsored by the staff right here at Horizon. So make sure you thank them for sponsoring that. They feel, and we feel, that it's important to recognize you guys for the great things that you do. When you go above and beyond and when you're doing the things that you need to do, we want to just make sure that we catch you guys doing that stuff so that you know that's the great stuff that you need to be doing. Sports. Boys basketball has started 7th and 8th grade. Definitely want to encourage everyone to be a part of going to those games. If you choose to go to the games, though, just as a reminder, please do not hang out outside of the gym. Pick a gym, the upper gym, the lower gym, where you're going to be, and make sure you're in the bleachers and not just hanging around outside of the gym. So we just want to make sure that we're doing things right, because that's where supervision is, and also that you have a ride home after the game. That's really all I have. My challenge for you guys is to remember to keep things kind with each other, and I really want you guys to really make someone's day in a positive way. And not necessarily someone that you know, but maybe someone that you don't know. Maybe that's a smile, a high five, a hello. You know, if you see someone that's by themselves, help them out. Ask them how they're doing, and tell them you're glad to see them. This is a great place with great kids, but if we don't reach out and invest in one another, we've really missed an opportunity. So I want you guys to have a great weekend. Enjoy it, and we'll see you next time on the Frantic Files. That tonight's gonna be a
good night. That tonight's gonna be a... Welcome to
Ginger Broadcasting. Golly, that cheeseburger last week was pretty good.
It looked like it.
I'm over that now. I want Italian.
Well, you're in luck. We were having chicken Alfredo with garlic toast this week for lunch.
Sweet Caroline, yes.
What'd you say?
Yes.
No. Before that.
Sweet and Caroline.
Whoa, wasn't that last week's song?
Yeah. Sweet Caroline by Neil Diamond was last week's song.
I know it was. Now let's see who gets. Gracie Kazapla, 6th grade.
Yeah. Stupid bird. No name.
Regan Miller, 6th grade.
You can read that.
I don't want to read it. Allie Ames, 6th grade.
I'm surprised that a certain person didn't get picked.
Who dat?
Logan Tibbetts, my son.
Does he really need a prize when it's his birthday this weekend?
Oh. I think it's okay.
Well, I think that's it. We did B, L, N, N, and T.
Yeah, and Ginger's singing off.
I can't sing.
Well, goodbye, Hawks. I'm just gonna watch some Sparrow Plays, the best YouTuber.
Good night, I feel it. That tonight's gonna be.
Welcome to This Week on Sports. I'm McKinley.
And I'm Beth.
He shoots and he scores!
Woohoo! And the crowd goes wild!
You know what we need?
Supporters at the HMS games.
Yeah, and guess when those athletic supporters need to show up?
To cheer on 7th grade team, you need to show up on January 30th at Evergreen.
And on the 31st, you can root them on against Green Acres.
We don't want to forget about the 8th grade hoopsters.
You can help them next week at HMS against the Grizzlies. And if you're a super fan, you'll travel to Green Acres next Thursday as they take on the Bruins.
We've recently heard from 7th and 8th grade basketball players, so now let's chat with one of the coaches.
Welcome to Hawk Talk, Mr. Frankham. We have some questions we'd like to ask you.
How many years have you been coaching?
15.
Wow, that's a lot.
It's a few.
Who's your favorite basketball team?
Well, of course, my 7th grade basketball team is my favorite basketball team, but my second favorite is Gonzaga Bulldogs.
What do you enjoy about coaching the boys team?
I like coaching both boys and girls, but what I really enjoy is the team aspect of the game, and that you have to be team players in order to be winners, and that's that kind of goes with the game. It's a team game, and you have to play the game as a team, or you're not going to be successful.
Good luck with your season, Mr. Frankham, and thank you for your time.
Thank
good
you.
Good luck next week, boy ballers. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night.
my Hawk homies. We're back for more.
That was cringy, but I kind of liked it. Let's do this.
Get out of here.
I'm back.
We're always looking, working on our character at Horizon, and we have some simple ways for you to build your character.
How's that?
First of all, in the cafeteria, you can make sure there are no more than 16 people at your table, so you can clean up after yourself and don't throw food.
Sounds simple enough, and also if you go to Chester to pick up a sibling, remember you are representing HMS, and that you need to be respectful and follow the rules and expectations.
And lastly, we all could be more empathetic.
Tell us more, please.
Being empathetic means putting yourself in someone else's shoes and thinking about how they may feel in a certain situation.
Oh yeah, not everyone has what we have, so don't assume that they do.
I do assume that the dankest Hawk Talk ever is ready to be over.
Oh, shizzle, all you homies out there.
Make it a great weekend, and we'll see you next week when we start our third quarter.
Lato Danko Gato.
After a while, Crocodile. Oh my god, jump out that sofa, let's kick it off.